Hey guys, and welcome to another review of Head-to-Head 8. We're in round 2 now, and this is the first matchup. Firstly, I'm sorry that it took so long, but I just didn't have any time. I had to work, yeah, most of the time, and when I didn't have to work, I had to sleep, and then I had friends over and my family over, and you know, you can't tell your family they've driven 300k, and I don't have time because I need to record a video, so that wasn't an option. So, and today is the first day that I actually have time. So I will do the recordings now. And the first matchup will be the Icons versus Heaven's Gallery. And we'll start with the Icons Park. Tubiao Action Park. First of all, in just in case you're wondering, no, your screen isn't broken, they just use a different color palette. It's everything is a little bit brighter than it usually would be. Or at least that's what it feels like. So, where do we start? First of all, this is obviously a city park. Placed in Japan, I'd say. Or in China. Well, China. Yeah, it's in the middle of the city. There are the surroundings to the city, which are incredibly, incredibly well made. I did have a look at the park beforehand, so I'm not entirely blind in this. As you say, then we have a big fucking ass traffic jam. We have a crash, car crash over here, right there. Then we have I didn't notice the working elevators in the skyscrapers. Okay, I won't dwell too long here because the highway is really fucking loud. So we just be a little bit to the side so that the highway doesn't kill your ears and my ears. Yeah, then we have all these lovely buildings. I mean, the interior is not, well, it is actually well detailed, but the exterior is what's really killing me. Okay, there are a few glitches here and there, or there are many glitches here and there and everywhere. But the pure detail on those facades is just wow. And all this, I mean, I don't know how to express that, but there are so many little details on the walls. There's so much junk on the walls, like the ACs and then the little, what the fuck they are called, I don't know actually. And everything is so overloaded on those walls, and that makes them look so fucking realistic. Because walls like, or buildings like this is what you have in mind when you picture a Chinese suburbia. Not a big like downtown areas, but the simpler suburban style of buildings. I mean, this year as well, the advertising sign, it's just, come on. Or the electric cables. Yeah, I think sum it all up on a detail level, this park is one of the best I have ever seen. This building as well. I mean, it is a very loud park. You have to. That may be a down point. McDonald's. Oh, okay. Oh, that's brilliant. Okay, so what we have here are two buses. And there is clearly written the logo of Theme Park Review on those buses. I mean, you can't read it, but the color palette, also the color scheme of the logo is the same as on Theme Park Review. And there we have the little kiddie coaster, which is broken. And a mechanic that says Damn Coaster Twist. So this is TPR, Theme Park Review, visiting this little park and crashing the coaster. That's a brilliant small detail. I mean, I noticed that the coaster tour is a thing and that the ride was broken before, but I didn't actually have a look at the buses, so I was wondering which group this was supposed to be. But now we know. So let's get over to the coaster. So we do have the little big apple, or small or broken apple, in that case here. And then we do have two rather brilliant rides, and brilliant in the way that they are absolutely shit. These are Chinese knockoff coasters, and I've never in my life seen them made so well in RCT. The ugliness, the weirdness, the sheer brutal the violence of those coasters. And you can feel the pain watching this in game. And that I think that's one of the biggest compliments that you can make to someone trying to build a Chinese knockoff in RCT. The support work is so well done as well. I really love this ride. And then we do have, of course, the Chinese knockoff SLC. Oh, the fucking highway. Oh, where is it? There it is. Flying Dragon in Bamboo Forest. I really like this one too, the very, very, very slow lift hill. That's a brilliant detail. And then another thing I just noticed is that there is like a gap between these two barrel rolls, which is typical for those courses as well. And I really like this park. So that's that. Then we do have, of course, be quiet, bad ride. Then we do, of course, have I don't want to scream. We do, of course, have the giant Ferris wheel. I mean, it looks good. There's, but we have seen many giant Ferris wheels these days, so nothing too special. Then we do have the little disco coaster over here. I won't go near that because that one, you know, nah. Your ears, my ears. Little helicopter ride. Yeah, happy to ride. The other rides are nothing special. But as I said, I really like the detailing. The suburban or the town part of the park is definitely what stood out to me the most. Then the two, of course, the two well-made knockoffs, and all the little details, like for example the TPR thing. Yeah. Okay, I'd say that's it for this park. And we'll head over to the next park, which was made by Heaven's Gallery. Oh, I don't know what to save. Heaven's Gallery. And it's called Ferrera della something. Maybe I should know that. Ferra del Flamengo. Do Flamengo. I think I just killed that pronunciation. I mean, with kill, I mean, I literally slaughtered it to death. Okay, so we do have the subway, the metro station, which is really messy. Okay, also, what should I say? Okay, this park is also a little town park. But it is not in some weird place in China, but in Rio de Janeiro, I guess. And I read me to just say in Rio, but there is only one Rio, so it must be Rio de Janeiro. Where to start? Let's start also with the surroundings. So we do have this little market here, which I really like. Are these burning flower beds? Oh no, this is supposed to be a grill, okay. Little town area. I mean, in every other way, I would say this town area is really well made, and it's great, and it's a great detail, and it's and everything. But after seeing what the icons did to China, this seems a bit it's just not on the same level. I mean, what is great is the little. But suspended control. Well, they're fucking. What I do like is the detailing on the inside of the houses. That's something that wasn't that big of a deal on the Icons Park. The facades, the outside of the buildings, that it's just not on the same level as the Icons Park. Switching over to this side. I like this side a lot more. I mean, it looks a little bit like, not exactly favela, but going in that direction. Like a poorer part of town. And I really like the look and the style of it. There's junk and trash everywhere. Rats, obviously. As you just saw. Or are these not supposed to be birds? Yeah, birds. Yeah, but that is supposed to be red. Okay. Who was the show if I saw the public which wasn't there? Okay, let's start with the thing back here. I have no idea what it is. It's obviously it is an old, like an old coaster, but I don't understand where it's coming from and where it's would where it would have gone if it was still there, because there it was just straight to walk into the fire. Into the town, that's not a good thing. And Vekoma didn't exactly do curved lift hills, so that wouldn't be an option either. But okay. Let's forget about that. Then the next one would be this lovely thing here, the Pepsi Catapult. I mean, I've written one of those error coasters in Blackpool 3 years ago. They are fun, but not exactly my cup of tea. But it fits in a background of the park. If you download the parks and you go into the README, then you'll find where this park is coming from and what it is and stuff like that. And I oh, that's an actually Möbius. Oh, jeez. Okay, great. I think the layout of this coaster is great. Serpentine de Fogo. I mean, it is just an old 60s Möbius wooden coaster. Nothing too special, but yeah, as I said, I really like it. Then we have one of those little fuckers here. The Euro coaster, yeah, of course. That's great. Yeah, I don't want to go into the detail of that. I mean, layout wise, I've been on one of those things, but I did not enjoy it that much, and I don't want to relive my old pain. The Schwarzkopf is looking great. I really like the layout of it. Really like this coaster. I think it's a bit if they would have Husqvarna here, if they would have put in the gondolas like on the middle floor, I think that would have been
better. I'm so sorry.
I mean, it looks good, but and it's more realistic if you want to have the peeps to enter and leave the ride directly and yeah and blah blah blah, but you don't have to do that here. So you theoretically you don't have to do it here either, so you just lift them up there and then let them fly over here. Would look better as a whole, I think. Then we have the little X car. The Skyloop from Maurer. With the right trains. I I really like the top fuel dragster right here down here. That's a great little thing. Then we do have the Haunted Mansion. What do you think? The facades are looking great. The ghost was a great little detail. Didn't notice that before. I just wanted to say that theoretically, if they would have let the or cut the trees down and then make the cutaway view right here so that you can look into the mansion, that would have been a great thing to do. But then on the other hand, they put a ghost there to I mean, there's a ghost, so you don't really need that. Then we do have the dancing people, right, which I have no idea how that is done, but the peeps are always looking at you as a viewer, and that's just freaking me out to no avail. They do have custom music in this park, but I'm sure I didn't get to install it properly because I didn't hear any custom music. Which is sad, because once I knew how it is done, and now I'm just... I put it where I thought I have to put it, but then nothing happens, so I guess, yeah. I don't know. Not that important, custom music. So that's that. I'd say we wrap it up for today. Wrap it up, sorry. I'm going to record the second match with version 1. Right after this recording, so that you get at least the first two matches right after one after the other. The link to the downloads is in the video description, so if you want to check those two out, you can go there. The voting is already closed. The icons won by a landslide, actually. So you don't have to vote anymore. But yeah, that's it. Check the parks out, leave a comment. Either over here or on the elements. Just to let the guys know that build the parks that they did a good job, or a bad job, or a job at all. And yeah, see you guys in the next episode. Till then, take care.